And this is, we can say, most confusing question and also most wrong answer which was marked by students was obviously option A, but this is the wrong answer. So you need to identify the bacterial infection. This may look seemingly one-liner type of question, but there is a lot in the options actually which you have to know, otherwise you might not answer this. The answer for this question is Pemphigus neonatorum. Okay, so let us see one by one each of the options. So this is a Bologna textbook of dermatology in which it is clearly mentioned that under gram-positive bacteria, that is staphylococcal, streptococcal infections, you can see impetigo. Under impetigo, in the synonyms, you can clearly notice that Pemphigus neonatorum is mentioned as one of the synonym, and also you can notice that Staphylococcal Scarlet Skin Syndrome, which is also called as Ritters disease, it is also called as in few textbooks as Pemphigus neonatorum. Very, very important. This is not a type of pemphigus. It is a bacterial infection. If it has to be a pemphigus which can be seen in the children, in the newborn, we are going to call it as neonatal pemphigus. Neonatal pemphigus. But not Pemphigus neonatorum. Okay, both of them are completely different conditions. Neonatal pemphigus is the type of pemphigus which occurs in the newborns due to the transfer of the autoantibodies through the placenta from the mother. Okay, and this is Ecthyma contagiosum. This is also taken from our Rook's textbook. As you can see, ORF virus. It is a parapox virus basically causing this condition which is called as ecthyma contagiosum, where due to the frequent handling of the animals like sheep, goats, reindeer, there is going to be transfer of these viruses and there will be lesions at the contact site. Okay, usually it is hands where the animal handlers are going to handle the animals. And as I told you, ecthyma is of three types. Pyogenicum. So Ecthyma pyogenicum is a bacterial infection, and in fact this is a variant of impetigo itself, but in impetigo the involvement is going to be only up to the epidermis, whereas here it is going to be little more deeper. Okay, little more deeper. That is the reason why there is an involvement of dermis happening, because of which the lesions are going to heal with ulceration. And most common site for ecthyma pyogenicum is lower limbs, and most common organism is streptococcus rather than staphylococcus. And now coming to the next type of ecthyma, that is, so this is ecthyma pyogenicum, which is the first type of ecthyma. Second type is ecthyma gangrenosum, and this is caused by a Pseudomonas aeruginosa infection. So this is also bacterial infection, where there are going to be hemorrhagic necrotic changes over the skin, and along with that there will be septicemia. So now coming to the third type, this is interesting, ecthyma contagiosum. This is a viral infection. Very, very important for all of you to remember. It's a viral infection. It is not a bacterial infection. It is due to parapox virus, and it is also called as ORF disease. So it is parapox which is responsible for ecthyma contagiosum. And also yesterday I asked one more question, isotretinoin, what is the total cumulative dose? It is 120 to 150 milligrams per kilogram body weight, and you can see Dr. Lavanya Guru marked it right. Very good. Also minocycline answer was also marked right. So now I hope all of you know, this is a neutrophilic dermatosis. This is pustular psoriasis of pregnancy, and this is a viral infection. Viral infection. And now we are left out with Pemphigus neonatorum, which is a bacterial infection. I hope it is clear. So please guys, do give this a video a thumbs up, that is, like this video, and also do subscribe if you want more of this stuff. And also this is going to be our next topic of discussion, which is actually a June 2019